Hey folks, John Ferguson Smart here. I often get asked, how do you do in-sprint test automation? What's the secret of pulling it off? And generally, what I explain is that when people come to me with that question, they come to me from a perspective that they want to automate their manual test scripts, that they complete their testing. They complete their manual testing, they have a whole lot of manual test scripts, and then they want to automate them. Now, if you try to do that within the sprint, that's very, very hard, almost impossible, in fact. It's very difficult to complete your manual testing, to complete your exploratory testing, to wait for a feature to be stable, and then to go and write some automated scripts for it. That's virtually impossible to do within the sprint. It's pretty much a lost battle. But in-sprint automation really is an essential part of a smooth, agile process, especially if you're trying to do a DevOps continuous delivery type approach. So what do you do? Well, the trick is to forget about the concept of automating manual test scripts. That is not an efficient way of going about automation. The best way to do automation is to think in terms of the business requirements that you need to demonstrate. And how will you demonstrate them in an automated way? How can you prove to the business that a feature does what it's supposed to do in business terms? In other words, how do you automate your acceptance criteria? How do you turn your business requirements into an executable form? And when you think this way, it flips things around to from how do I demonstrate, how do I automate this test script to how do I demonstrate this feature in an automated way? And you can start thinking about it much earlier on in the sprint before work starts. You can start to collaborate with developers more effectively. You can start to get them involved in the automation as well. You can start to mix up UI and API or just do API or just do component level testing to whatever you need to do to demonstrate the feature. And that is the secret to getting in-sprint automation actually working. I want to talk in the next video, what I'll talk about is the other key to actually making that sustainable. But for now, that's all I wanted to talk about today. So thanks for listening, folks.